You don't mimic a mechanical system with an electronic system. You build an electronic system to do things that a mechanical system can't do. Doing products differently, but with an intent to make bike riding better, is kind of our goal. And that's where XX1 came from, that's where Eagle comes from, and that's where AXS is coming from, which is trying to make the bike ride better. I think you gotta get people into the red a little bit. When you start sweating, that's when it just really comes alive. You just push the button and what you want to happen, happens. And that's where we really focus, is making sure that it's right for riders. Pushing a shifter is not so hard today, but if you can make it easier, you can make it better, you can make it smoother, that's kind of what we wanted to do.
I didn't have really to think about or to use any force. I just pressed those buttons and the gears just jumped in.
AXS is the umbrella that all of SRAM and RockShox's electronic components live under. All these things come together to make the next generation of superbike. Basically, on a mountain bike, we have three functions. We have a C-post, we have an inboard shift, and we have an outboard shift. Those three functions are controlled by two controllers at the moment. You can use the AXS app to tell the products to do exactly what you want them to do. And that's what kind of gives us a lot of really cool opportunities in the future to do neat stuff. You could use drop bar controllers with mountain bike rear derailleur and cassette. So you can build any kind of bike you want to build. The app does give you the opportunity to do a lot of cool stuff. Not just change what the controllers can do, but also you see how many shifts you've done, you see how many hours you've ridden, you can check battery levels, you can see service alerts, like you've ridden your bike 20 hours, so maybe you should lube your chain, that kind of stuff. It's a really neat tool, but it's not a tool that's necessary to ride your bike, so you kind of get the option to use it or not use it.
If you don't think it's the sickest bike in the world, like, you just hate technology. Like, that's flat out, man. It is the sickest looking bike ever. Just no cables up there, no spaghetti mask.
What we see today is you get about, in the system, 20 to 25 hours of ride time. Cool thing about it is that you don't have to drag your bike up the steps to charge battery. You simply pop it off and plug it into your computer, into a USB. It's also nice because the seat post and the derailleur use the same battery. So if you have one product that's a little bit lower on energy than the other, you can swap them around and use the same battery for multiple things. You can also carry a spare, and that would work on either your derailleur or your seat post. We built safety devices into this derailleur, one of which is a gearbox clutch. If it gets hit, it will move out of the way. It will then come back to the original position that it was in before. So in most cases, you don't even notice that something has happened. There's no need to reset it. It's simply a safety feature built into the derailleur to make sure that in the event of a smash, that nothing breaks. You remove hydraulic cables, you remove mechanical shifting and cables. The bike gets cleaner, it gets quieter. There's less things bouncing around on the front of the bike. It's really just a kind of an ultimate solution to making a bike one complete product, which actually translates to a really positive trail experience.